In this video, I will demonstrate a really interesting new approach that can dramatically improve your interactions with AI. That is called GraphRAG. You don't have to know anything about GraphRAG or RAG or AI in order to understand it. And actually, to make it easier for you to follow me, I will use the app that I developed that is called Infranodus that has GraphRAG built in and that visualizes this approach. So you can see really easily how it works and understand it in an intuitive way. As an example, I will use a paper on GraphRAG written by Microsoft researchers. So we will analyze the content of this paper using GraphRAG with the help of the tool that I developed, Infranodus. And I will show you how you can use the graph to understand what are the main concepts inside, how they relate to one another, how you can also use the graph to see the main topics in this document, and most importantly, how you can use it to then zoom into the parts of the content that are particularly interesting to you and use this information in order to generate really interesting prompts for your AI models. And this is what makes GraphRAG different from any other approach, because if you don't have this kind of visual or knowledge graph representation of your content, you will only be able to interact with the chunks of the text, how the traditional RAG works. And with the graph, you actually have an overview and you can zoom in onto the parts that you find relevant and focus the model to interact specifically in relation to these concepts with you. So if you're interested, keep watching and I will demonstrate how it works. So first of all, if we have a document, let's say this is a document on GraphRAG, it's a PDF. If we would like to talk to it using an AI model, a traditional approach would be to upload it somewhere like ChatGPT, or if you have more advanced tools such as DeFi, which allows you to create AI workflows, you just upload this document here, then it splits it into chunks. And then when you ask a question about this document to the system, it is using traditional RAG system, retrieval augmented generation. And what happens is that it creates a vector representation of this text, and then it finds the chunks of the text, which are closest vectors based on the same vector representation. So basically what happens is that the model looks what you're asking about. So you have the words paper and about. So it kind of understands you're asking about the paper. And then it's going to find you the chunks that have paper and about and some related words, related not in the context of this paper, by the way, but in general. And then it will show you some chunks. So it's going to be not so relevant most of the time. So for instance, here you see this something about tech policy and government regulation. So it's a specific example from this paper where they're analyzing a specific domain. It's not talking about what the paper is about actually. So the responses that you get will be not so precise because the information that you extract using the traditional RAG is also not precise. So I'll show you here. You can actually create a chatbot in DeFi and then you attach a context and then you can ask the questions. And if you ask, what is it about? Let's say, it's a very general question. I will ask it in DeFi. You see, it says that the context provides a variety of topics. It discusses a framework for discussing tech policy and government regulation based on podcast episodes. I mean, this is completely not related to this actual document, right? So that's quite interesting because it just extracted the examples that they provide in the paper and not the actual content. And that's the problem that you have with traditional RAG systems. And while ChatGPT, for instance, has much better implementation of that, you will still run into the same problem. So this is where GraphRAG is very useful, because what it does is that before allowing you to interact with the text, it represents it as a graph. So here in Infranodus, we actually use this approach since 2014. This is this PDF document. I represented it as a graph inside the Infranodus browser extension. And then it shows me what are the main entities in this document. So for example, I can see that it's talking about graphs, obviously nodes here, graphs and nodes. And it also highlights the strongest connections here. So I can see how the information travels and circulates in this document, right? And then I can see that they're also talking about data sets and communities and large language models. So that already gives me a really nice overview of the content in this document and allows me to zoom into the parts that might be interesting for me as a researcher. So for example, as I already know about graphs and networks, I know that communities are quite important. So here I'm going to click on the community and see that, for instance, community and entity. So where are they talking about communities and entities? I can click on those nodes, then I click on the context, and then I see a statement directly from this document where they're talking about these particular entities, this particular concept. So it's really useful to me because I can find directly the parts of the document that are relevant to me. But what's even more important is that if I then try to use the AI to speak to this document, I will use exactly the statements that I found based on these relations between the entities in order to generate much more precise response. So if I click those two, for instance, community and entity, and then I go into my chat mode here, let me do this here, and then I will ask, what is it about? By the way, if I click on the context, I can see that I selected those two nodes. And then when I create a response, now it's going to take those statements that relate to those two entities from the graph and then generate a response that will be highly relevant to the question that I'm asking. So it's going to be much more precise than whatever it is that I would obtain using another approach. So here it says, the text focuses on creating a knowledge graph from source documents aimed at generating community summaries by identifying closely related entities and their impact. This approach emphasizes the interconnectedness of communities within a graph framework. So look what I just did. I selected the part of the document that is highly relevant to me, communities and entities. And then I went into chat and I generated a response where it's talking about this particular topic, what the document said about those topics. So I would never get this with normal AI, this level of precision with such a general wide open question, right? So this is one of the best demonstrations of why GraphRAG actually works and how it works. So you get much more precise results. And now to go into the demonstration of how it all works, I will actually use the graph that is generated by Infranodus. So we've been using this approach, as I said, since 2014 when Infranodus first appeared. And the general method here is to take a text that you're analyzing. In this case, it's this paper on GraphRAG from Microsoft. And you represent it as a text network where the concepts are the nodes, co-occurrences are the connections. And then you build a graph from it, and then you build communities. So you detect which nodes belong more often together. So for example, here I can see that this green cluster, let's say it's graphs and communities, this is more often occurring together. Then there's one on language model where it's about question answering, retrieval augmented generation, RAG, and so on. So this is another cluster. And then there is one, for example, on data set diversity, and this is another cluster. So it gives me a really good understanding of the main topics inside. And this, as a user, it allows me to see what is the main content inside, so what are the main topics, how they relate to one another. This is really great. The same thing goes for the model. If AI gets this information, it understands much more about the structure of the document. So when you ask it general questions or some questions that demand some kind of reasoning, it's going to be able to have a holistic view of this knowledge that you're analyzing, right? But then another advantage here is that you can also zoom in onto the specific topics, like I just did here with the nodes. I can also focus on dataset diversity, for example, and I can say, okay, what are the statements that are talking about dataset diversity? So for example, here I see the statements which relates to this topic. So that's quite interesting because then I can zoom in onto the parts of the document which are particularly interesting for me, in this case that relate to dataset diversity. And on top of that, I can then, by selecting this topic, I can go into my chat mode, right? And then I can ask it to generate something for me where it would relate to those topics. So for example, I could say, what are the main issues regarding data diversity? Then when I ask this question, it's now going to use this context, the statements that belong to this particular topic, dataset diversity, right? So then the answer that it's going to provide is going to be much more precise than I would normally get if I just made a search for it, because now it's taking all the relations into account. So here it says the main issues regarding data diversity involve in ensuring a rich variety of perspectives within data sets, as this enhances comprehension and relevance in applications like question answerings. Diverse data sets enable better evaluation across various domains, including science and podcasts. So this is great because it gives me a precise answer. I also have the references to the particular parts of the document where these statements appear, even some references to the scientific papers which are talking about it. So there I get a very precise response, which would be relatively hard to get if I use the traditional RAG approach, where I would just ask about diversity. It would find me the chunks, but it wouldn't have all this rich relational data that I have inside this representation. So this is another advantage of using GraphRAG. And then one other thing that I want to show you is that based on these topics, you can also identify the gaps. So you can ask the system to generate some gaps in the content and to show you what are the parts that are missing. So for example, here, in this particular document, there is a cluster on community graphs and on graph technologies, but they're not so well connected together. So now I can use this insight that there is a gap, a blind spot in this document, in this research paper, to generate an interesting research question that could help me bridge this gap and maybe generate a new idea that would help me develop this whole research further. So for instance, here I can say, how can graph community detection algorithms like Leiden and Levan enhance the efficiency of knowledge graph-based retrieval augmented generation systems in platforms such as Neo4j and LangChain? So for example, can we use more community detection algorithms in those platforms and how we can use them? So here it's proposing me to think how I could apply all those metrics from graph sciences in platforms such as Neo4j and LangChain. And by the way, I don't think that they have those implemented. We have them inside infranodus. This is why we can get these really precise structural insights about this graph, because this is actually based on Levan community detection. And then once we detect communities, we can identify the gaps. So this is kind of like a demonstration of this approach in action, how it works. We use the community detection algorithm to identify the clusters and then to find the gaps between them and to generate a new idea. And this is actually what the system proposed as how we can develop GraphRAG further. And that's what's missing from most applications as well. So this is how you would use it to get a general overview, to zoom into the specific concepts, and then to identify the gaps. GraphRAG itself, in this paper, the way that they propose us to use it is to basically use the topical structure in order to get the summaries of each topic. So for example, language models, then knowledge evaluation, community graphs, and then you combine the summaries to get like a really good representation of the document. So we can also do that using infranodus. We can click on each topic and then generate summary here of each topic. So we'll understand that that the text is talking about different language models, Llama and GPT and so on, and how we can improve them for question answering. Then, for instance, if I click here on community graphs and I click on summary, again, I'm gonna get another summary. So you can do all that with infranodus using the graph. But I think that, in fact, there's a much more interesting use case where you actually use the graph to navigate to the parts of the content that you find interesting, like I did in the beginning of this video, to zoom in to the parts that you find relevant to you, and then to see in which context they appear, and then feed them to the AI model to generate questions, ideas, summaries, or to have a chat with them. So this is how I would suggest to use graphs, and soon we'll make it available via API, so you would be able to attach it to a system like DeFi, for instance, and to use some of Infranodus' structural insights about the graph behind your knowledge in order to generate better responses. By the way, you can also use it inside Obsidian. So if you're using Obsidian, you can install the Infranodus GraphView extension. And what happens here is that I have a page where I was just writing some ideas about GraphRAG, and here it visualizes for me what are the main concepts inside. So I can use that same approach. I have this long document where I was just writing down some notes. Now I can use it to get a general understanding of the main topics I covered, which can be really helpful because I can see if I'm missing anything Or I can also zoom into the parts that are underdeveloped. So for example, distributed complexity. That sounds interesting. I'm gonna zoom into this topic, click on the context, see in which context it appears, even try to visualize it here so I can see it in context. Okay, so I see that there is a RAG challenge integrating the main knowledge from distributed sources and how you can use knowledge graph to connect them. That's great because it reminds me how I can use GraphRAG to connect different sources together by having a general knowledge graph that encompasses all the knowledge. So that's a great insight that reminds me also how I can maybe implement it inside Infranodus as well. So this is just a demonstration for how you could use it for ideation based on your own notes inside Obsidian. So it's the same approach. And having that additional structural information is really helpful because then if you zoom into this and then you go into the chat mode here, you can actually ask the system, so you check if the context is right. Yes, we have this topic selected. How we can improve Infranodus with this approach, right? So it already has this context in mind. So when it's gonna answer that question, it's gonna take this topic and this statement into account and then try to think how to improve my own tool with it, right? So here it's saying we can improve Infranodus by using inductive biases to design structures that efficiently capture essential domain knowledge, reducing complexity, leveraging a distributed knowledge graph. Here it's talking about the topic that I selected, enhances contextual relevance while adaptive multi-agent systems manage task complexity effectively. Actually, you know what? I really like it. I'm gonna save it into my notes and have it ready for me for next time I use it. Here I have it saved in the main version of Infranodus. And in the main version of Infranodus, you actually can use the same approach as well. You select the parts that you find interesting, and then you use the AI model to interact with this particular part and to generate ideas for it. So I hope that gives you a nice visual representation of how GraphRAG works. I will make another video on the technical implementation as soon as we have it out available as an API. But what I wanted to show in this video is that you don't need to use some complex tools like Neo4j or some code to actually get into GraphRAG and make it useful for you. You can use Infranodus, you visualize your information as a graph, and then you know you can use all these insights that the graph enables you to have through selecting the nodes and communities and gaps in order to generate ideas and to already start getting much better quality of responses from your models. So try it out on infranodus.com and let me know if you have any questions. Thank you.